Hey, what's up, guys? I wanted to make a video talking about how therapy is going for depersonalization. And so I started therapy in February of this year. And so it's been about 4 months since I've started to go to therapy. And overall, I'd say that it's been quite an experience. It's basically like a really complicated type of relationship to be in. And what I mean by that is you're going to be talking about kind of your deepest emotions and your deepest experiences and thoughts. But at the same time, there's this kind of wall between you and the therapist, and you're not supposed to get too close. You're not supposed to, like, if you're like expressing something that's really hard, they're not supposed to like give you a hug or comfort you in that way. And so that element has kind of, it's made therapy kind of weird. And I just wanted to express that this, like, going to therapy for depersonalization is not gonna be like bam, like you're better. It's gonna take some time for you to even get comfortable with the therapist. And so it's been 4 months for me, and I would say that it's just a learning experience. Like, you definitely, it's like you're in a relationship with a person, and it kind of reminds me of like romantic relationships in a way. Like for me, in past romantic relationships, after a given number of months, sorry, it just seems that I'm kind of going through the motions, and the specific elements about the relationship, or like the complexion of the relationship itself with a therapist kind of adds to this distance between us. And so it's like I want to be able to fully receive the comfort and empathy and feel comfortable sharing myself, but at the same time, it's like I don't fully trust the therapist yet, because it just feels really unnatural. It's not like a real relationship. I mean, it is, but it's really not. And so that's been a little part of therapy being a little bit uncomfortable. And yeah, so I really wanted to just let you guys know that therapy isn't easy, and healing from this stuff isn't easy, and it's gonna take more time than you think, for the most part. And there's so many factors that contribute to how quick you're gonna heal. For me, this whole 2016 has been extremely stressful for me, and so that's led to a lot of other things that have been going on. And so it's really hard to become healed, I guess, not become healed, but kind of get over these things when you're in a constant mode of stress. And what that's looked like for me is, this is my fourth year of college. The last two quarters have been really, really difficult. I've been thinking a lot about what I'm gonna do with my life, and I'm a graphic design major here at my school, and it's been just so stressful because I've been required to do a lot more graphic design work, and that means more just sitting at my desk, not doing much in terms of like physical activity, and being on the computer for too long can really make me feel disconnected from my body and the environment. And so all of that, so school combined with not exercising as much because I've been doing more schoolwork, plus trying to do this emotional healing work, all of that has just elevated my stress levels, and it's caused just not the right environment to heal. And because of this, all this stress, plus me being vegan, I haven't been supplementing B12. My B12 levels dropped, and so I've had all these crazy symptoms, and now my thyroid is underperforming, so I have a slightly hypothyroidism, and you know, just all this stuff is going on. And it's really like, if you're to do the kind of psychological emotional healing that you want to be able to do, you generally gotta like feel good. And for me, the last 6 months, I haven't been feeling the best. And more specifically in the last month, I've just really gotten these symptoms of B12 deficiency and hypothyroidism. And so it's just been a real challenge, and all of the physical stuff that's been going on with me has affected my emotional health and well-being and my sensitivity. And so going to therapy has been even more stressful because I'm feeling kind of not my best, and so I'm more sensitive in therapy, and it feels a little bit more out of control. And so there's just all this stuff that's going on. And I guess my message through all of like this stuff, all of the crap, all of this bad stuff that's going on, is that it's everybody's like experience is going to be different. And like, no matter what's happening, like, just think of it as everything that's happening to you is happening for a reason. And that kind of just relieves the stress. Like, this was meant to happen. This is supposed to be a part in the story where I learn something. And for me, it's basically teaching me to, you know, take better care of my body and myself, because it affects everything. And honestly, if you don't feel healthy, and if you don't have health, then you have nothing. So I just wanted to leave you guys with that. In terms of depersonalization and derealization, it's kind of been a roller coaster. Overall, within the last few years, it's gotten better. But in times of stress, it gets worse. And right now, it's not that bad. I've been doing what I can to kind of keep the stress low and really just accept the moment that's happening right now. But there's still some work to be done. And yeah, there's some work to be done in terms of my emotional healing and physical well-being, but it's good. It's something to work on. And yeah, so I just want to make this video for you guys. Hope you guys are doing well, whoever's watching this video. Never give up. Like, just never give up, no matter what. You got this. We all got this. Get out in the sun. Be goofy, be stupid, be weird, because those are like the best things to be. You just gotta be weird. Gotta own your weirdness. You gotta dress like you're homeless. You gotta, I don't know what you gotta do to own your weirdness, but you just gotta be yourself. You gotta love yourself. And that's kind of like the core message through like all of this, is just teaching. It's basically like you gotta learn how to love yourself no matter what. So, all right, I'll leave you guys with that. Peace.